हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम। शुरू करने से पहले आई रिक्वेस्ट यू टू प्लीज सब्सक्राइब द चैनल एंड प्रेस द बेल आइकन फॉर द लेटेस्ट अपडेट। सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। 3, 2, 1 स्टार्ट। मिस्टर चेयरमैन सर, आई हैव स्पेंट सेवरल ईयर्स वॉचिंग एंड पार्टिसिपेटिंग डेवलपमेंट इन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर एंड देयर फोर समबडी डिस्क्राइब्ड मी एज अ विटनेस टू हिस्ट्री। Sir, I find it difficult on this occasion to find adequate words to express my grief and anguish at what is happening there. This time, there has been an unprecedented outburst of frustration, of rage, and of anguish. The leader of the opposition, in his effective opening speech, has made many points which I do not want to reiterate. He has mentioned several factors that had been responsible over the years and decades to build up this sort of resentment. We are seeing their grievous deaths and injuries to hundreds of people. They all are citizens. If young people, young citizens are blinded, we have to have some compassion and understanding. Whenever there is a small accident in which 2 or 3 people die, we get up and say how sorry we are. We send our condolences. But what about the recent happenings in Kashmir? Is the nation awake and aware of the immensity of what is happening there and of the depths of the frustration and pain of the people? We have got to share that pain. If we say that they are a part of India, then India has to got to share the pain and the frustration and the rage that is there and try and see what can be done to look into the matter. The leader of the opposition talked of the use of disproportionate force. If that has happened, then it would be inquired into because that is not acceptable. Sometimes force has to be used. But disproportionately, force is surely something which can be condoned. As I said, this time the youth and the intelligentsia in the valley are alienated. The press has stopped printing, the newspapers are not coming out any longer. There has been a curfew for 10 days. Can you imagine what it would be like to live for 10 days without being able to go out of one's house, even to get medicines or to get essential commodities? And it is going on. Marriages have been put off. Even funerals are not taking place. The whole situation has become such that the entire valley is in the grip of something of a trouble crisis. Sir, I am not sure whether you fully understand or appreciate the depth of the whole affair. I know Pakistan will obviously fan the flames. This is what they have done right from the very beginning, even before my father signed the instrument of accession. Even before that, Pakistan had intervened with the tribal invasion in October 1947, and it will be continue to do it. It has done that all through these years. But simply to blame everything on the foreign hand, I would submit to this honorable house, is being unrealistic. We have to accept that we are facing a serious problem of trust, of credibility in the valley. It is a very serious problem, and this problem has to be tackled. Sir, we have to look within and introspect. It is not just the comfortable truth. Sometimes we have to face uncomfortable situation which we are facing today. There are only one way we can face it. You cannot face it with a war with Pakistan. You cannot face it with gun. You have got to face it with dialogue. In a democracy, the only way you can get over the most difficult of problems is through dialogue. But it must be a dialogue that cuts across all barriers, and it has to be within all stakeholders. Remember, there are stakeholders not just in Kashmir. There are stakeholders in Jammu and Ladakh also. The name of the state is not Kashmir. The name of the state is Jammu and Kashmir. It is the state which my father, forefathers created, and for which my father assigned the instrument of accession. It is not only the Kashmir Valley. Kashmir Valley is an important part of it. But there are stakeholders in Jammu. There are stakeholders in Kashmir. Within the valley, there are mainstream political parties, there are regional parties, and there are even separatist parties. You must talk to all them. Without talking, how can you come to any kind of conclusion? You must continue talking. Even at the height of the Second World War, Germany and Britain were talking. There have been round table conferences. There have been interlocutors. There have been series of attempts. But what happened? They were never followed up. But what happened? Do we have now the political will? I am not talking in terms of a party. It is not a party affair. We are not looking at it in a partisan manner. This is a national crisis. It is a national challenge. Stop. Okay friends, अगर आपको और कोई help चाहिए तो please comment section में हमें जरूर बताएं, and don't forget to like, share and subscribe.